สวัสดีค่ะ This is Pashree of BrandNow.Asia. Welcome to this episode, Business Insights by BrandNow.Asia. And today I have with me Mr. Lawrence Shaney. Welcome, Lawrence.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Lawrence and I are part of Proceed Asia, which is a mentoring group for blossoming startups. And he is the managing partner of GPS Legal. Recently, we were on a panel discussion to talk about the impact of the current pandemic, COVID-19. So I thought I'd bring him on board to talk about the implication for employers and employees. Mm-hmm. So before we get started, tell us about yourself.
Well, I moved to Asia about 30 years ago in 1990, and amongst other places, I've lived in Hong Kong and Beijing and Singapore, but have now found Thailand to be my permanent home, and I've been here for 15 years. Mm-hmm. I opened up GPS Legal in 2014 to serve underserved demand in the marketplace, but basically between the international very expensive law firms who serve a need for the international big multinationals, and the more local law firms who do a very good job serving the local market, but there was this underserved area that was for international or regional or SMEs that were coming into Thailand and needed that international service, but weren't really finding sufficient players in the market. So the demand far outstripped the supply.
Okay, great. So we were just discussing how a number of your clients are in the travel and tourism and hospitality industry. So, and they're being impacted by the current situation, yeah. So one hot topic has come up is the labor law section 75. You want to talk a little bit about that?
Sure. So section 75 of the Labor Protection Act, the revised version of 2008, provides for an employer to be able to furlough their staff, but outside of strict force majeure aspects. So if they find their business to be interrupted or unsustainable, either partially or wholly, then there's a provision that it would allow them to suspend their staff and pay them not less than 75% of their existing wage rate. The staff can either continue to work or not continue to work, up to what the employer's requirements are. And this they can continue this during the period of time of this work interruption. Now, whether or not the current virus is applicable remains undetermined. So the wording of the law is somewhat ambiguous. So if an employer is considering enacting this section, then we always advise our clients that we would talk to the Ministry of Labor, explain the circumstances at length, and they will assess it on a case-by-case basis. And then if the Ministry of Labor agrees, then what the benefit to the employer is that they don't have to go to each employee individually to seek permission. They have to give across the board. They make an announcement across to their business 3 days in advance, and then the provisions take effect.
Okay, I see. And recently, the Thai government had announced that COVID-19 is a serious communicable disease. Mm-hmm. So what is the implication of that?
So by declaring that COVID-19 is a severe communicable disease through the Communicable Disease Act, basically it gives the government expanded authority, and it also imposes certain obligations upon the individual. So very importantly, the obligations on the individual are that if you, as a business owner or as a family member, anybody that is within your purview, if you find out that they are sick, then you must notify a relevant authority within 3 hours of realizing that person is sick. Failing to do so could expose you to civil and criminal penalties. If it's determined that by failing to notify the authorities, you contributed to public risk or increased public risk, then the government could could come down on you quite severely.
Mm-hmm. I want to go back to the previous section when mm-hmm. we were discussing the labor law. We had touched on what are the rights of the employees in the event that they are ill.
So, okay, so actually if I could back up just a little bit when I was talking about Section 75, mm-hmm. which limits the reduction of wages to not less than 75%. Mm-hmm. An employer still has the if their business is so severely affected, you know, we have clients whose business has essentially evaporated. Mm-hmm. And so they're looking at business survival.
Yeah.
So if a business owner is in a situation where 75% is not sufficient, where mm-hmm. you've got to let go of staff or reduce working hours by 50% or even reduce wages by 50%, the law provides you the ability to do so, mm. but you have to then get the assent, the individual assent from each individual employee that they agree to that.
Mm-hmm.
If they don't agree, then you have a decision to make. The decision is to keep them on board mm. or to let them go, to terminate them. If you are forced, if they say no, I don't agree to the reduced work hours or the reduced wages,
mm-hmm.
then and you're forced to terminate them, then you go back to following the usual laws, the Labor Protection Act, which specifies a notice period according to the employment contract,
right.
usually one pay period,
right.
and then any severance that would normally be due.
Right.
From the employee's perspective, so Thailand basically has what's called a no work, no pay aspect. What that means is that if an employee feels that they need to take time off of work,
hmm.
the law provides for 30 days of mandatory or available sick leave.
Mm-hmm.
So they can claim sick leave, paid sick leave, for up to 30 days.
Mm-hmm.
If they exhaust that, then they still have available the annual leave that's provided in the employment contract.
Okay.
If they've exhausted both of those,
mm-hmm.
and they still need to take time off,
mm-hmm.
then it becomes unpaid leave. And
okay.
the employer is no longer the employer has no further obligation to pay them,
mm.
and an employee can continue to take unpaid leave so long as the employer allows them to do so. There will come a point where the employer says, "I either need you to come back to work, or you're not being here is affecting our business, and
right.
we'll have to let you go." In which case, then you revert back to the original provisions for the law.
Right. Yeah. Okay. So during the 30-day sick leave, which you said is provided mm-hmm. under the general labor law already, is the employee then obligated to show a medical certificate, or what?
Sure.
What are the standard procedure for that?
You follow company policy. So. The law specifies that you've got 30 days of medical leave. It then allows the employer some flexibility in terms of how that sick leave is activated.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of employers will say, you know, that they're not trying to run a kindergarten or anything. So they'll say, okay, if you've got 1 or 2 days of sick leave, I don't require a medical certificate, but
right.
anything longer than 3 consecutive days or 7 days in any certain period, 6 months, then you are required to provide a medical certificate. So that would still apply. If an employee is sick, they have to continue to notify their employer. Oftentimes, if you go to the doctor, the doctor will say, you know, you're being given
mm-hmm.
10 days leave. So
okay.
you notify your employer 10 days, and if at the end of that 10 days, if you still need more time off, then you are obligated to let your employer know. If you don't, then if you completely disappear from work, then the Labor Protection Act provides that if an employee doesn't show up for 3 consecutive days, even if there's an intervening holiday or weekend, so a Friday, Monday, Tuesday, or a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, then you can dismiss them with cause.
So
no severance.
Okay, and no notification.
Immediate termination, yeah.
Okay, I see. All right. There was this other thing that also came up, which is a term called force majeure. Could you tell us about that?
So force majeure is a provision in law that allows for the parties to a contract to be released from, or the affected party to be released from the obligations of that contract for a certain period of time under what is defined by as force majeure. Mm. Most people understand force majeure to be things like acts of God, things that are completely out of your control. So floods or tornadoes or hurricanes or, or you know, tsunamis or things like that that cause some kind of business interruption that you, there's no way you could have predicted it, there's no way you could have foreseen that it would happen. And so it allows you to either suspend your obligations for a period of time until the thing that caused that act of God is completed, and or if it continues for an indefinite period of time, then it allows the parties to terminate the contract according to the language of the force majeure clause. Currently, despite the Thai government having declared COVID-19 as a severe communicable disease, that doesn't necessarily mean that you have free reign to declare a trigger a force majeure. It really is going to depend on the what's in the language of your contract, or the circumstances that have led to it. So if the force majeure clause specifically says pandemic or epidemic, then you can trigger it. If it doesn't, then maybe it says something like disruption of supply chain. So if you are a supplier and you have factories or raw materials being sourced out of China, for instance, and those factories have been shut down and closed through no fault of your own, then you have there's the possibility that you have the ability to trigger force majeure. However, it's important to note that changing market conditions is not a force majeure action. So changing market conditions means just because you
just because your
hotel is now 20% occupancy instead of 90% occupancy, and maybe that's had a knock-on effect that you can't pay your bills. Sorry, but you still have to pay your bills. You can't say, well, I've got a force majeure because I don't have any guests staying at my hotel and I can't pay you my bills.
Okay, I see.
So it's something that if you think you might have a force majeure angle, then you probably should talk to your lawyer and find out and have them review your contract.
All right. Thank you so much for that.
You're very welcome.
Yeah, thanks for coming in. So how do people get in touch with you if they want your consultation?
So you can find us at www.gps-legal.com. We're also located at the end of Soi 23 on Sunkulit.
All right. Thank you so much again, Lawrence.
Thank you.
Sawadee ka.
If we may be of service to you or someone you know, please reach out to us. Thank you and have a great day.